Hello there, music lovers. Thank you so much for dropping by this channel. And I just wanted to talk a little bit about Johnny Marr. He has a new album that's going to be dropping this week called Call the Comet. It's his third solo album. And what's interesting about Marr is that, you know, he was with the Smiths. He was the guitar player from the Smiths, which is a great, great band. They should be in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. No question about it. The influence that they have had. You know, REM is in there. You know, it's kind of like if you got Yes in there, you got to have Genesis. You know, if you got one band, you got to have the other. You got to put in the Smiths. I made a video about five bands that should be in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. I'll put a link up to it. The Smiths are not in that video. they almost were. If I had to do another one, another five, they would definitely be in there. But Johnny Marr was the guitarist in that band, and when they broke up, a lot of people expected him to do a solo album. He never did. He didn't put one out until 2013, and that was a great, great album. I'll get to that in just a little bit. But after the Smiths broke up, Marr went on to just work with others. He was a studio guy, played with the Talking Heads, did some work with the Pet Shop Boys. He was a member of the Pretenders briefly in about 1987. Worked with Modest Mouse. He was a producer. You know, he's just kind of been the go-to guy, and never a solo album. Oh, he had this band with the guy from New Order, the singer there, and they were in that band Electronic. That was through the 90s. They were pretty cool. So always in bands, working for other bands, never put a solo album out. 2013 comes, he puts out a great album called The Messenger. And that's one of these albums where it's like every track is good. Like every song on that album is great. It's a five-star album. He put another album out after that pretty quickly called Playland. That was a good album. Not as great as The Messenger, but the albums are very similar. You could almost mix and match the songs and not even know where they came from. He's got this new album coming out, which sounds like it might have some different kind of things to offer, especially there's this new track called The Tracers. I'll put a link to it down below. That I thought that was a really cool song. Hadn't really heard him do that kind of thing before, although it is in his wheelhouse. Doesn't sound like the Smiths or anything. But the other single from this new album called Hi Hello sounds just like the Smiths. I mean, it takes you right back into like right before Louder Than Bombs or something. I mean, it's a really, really good song. Definitely check it out. I will put it down below. And you know, it just kind of got me thinking about other bands, you know, that have guys in them who never put solo albums out. You know, like, it seems to be the standard, you know, that you're in a band and eventually you put out a solo album, you know, especially a lot of the bands that I talk about here, like Yes and even Rush and Genesis and Journey and all these bands, you know, they eventually, somebody puts out a solo album, all of them, practically. But there are some bands out there that you don't see any solo stuff, like U2. You know, there's no Bono solo album, no Edge album. I would love to hear an Edge album. I don't know what it would be, but I would love to hear it. I think it could be a cool album. A band like Metallica, I know that they are not too, or at least they were, if you watched their therapy sessions, otherwise known as their film, Some Kind of Monster, where, you know, Jason Newsted came back to, you know, kind of sort some shit out. And, you know, Jason Newsted was their bass player that replaced Cliff Burton. And so when they got him in, they were really, really hard on him. And one of the things they didn't like is that Jason Newsted had this other band called Echo Brain. And so they didn't like the fact that he wasn't 100% in the Metallica camp. And so that caused a major, major problem. So that's why probably you don't see a Kirk Hammett solo album or a James Hetfield solo album. There are some bands I kind of get the sense that just work as a unit and there's no solo. So let me know what you think about that. How many bands can you think of that have like no solo albums? Put it down below. Let me know what you think about Johnny Marr. Check out these tunes. You think the Smiths should be in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame? You know, let me know. Put it down below. Give this video a thumbs up if you like it. Be sure to hit the subscribe button too, and I will talk to you later.